And Vito, I almost forgot. Joe called. He wants you should meet him at Freddy's.
How you doing this afternoon?
Hey, where the hell you been?
I came right over as soon as you called. What's going on?
You remember the wise guys we used to see when we was kids?
Yeah, why?
The guy we're meeting here is one of them. His name's Henry Tomasino. I think he's got something big for us.
Yeah, no shit.
Yeah. We're done with the small-time jobs. It's time to make some real shuttle. Here, he's coming. Don't say nothing stupid.
Hey, Henry, how are you?
Hiya, Joe. This the guy?
Yeah, this is Vito, an old friend of mine.
Good to meet you, Henry.
You vouch for him?
Absolutely, Henry. Trust him with my life.
Okay, listen. I got a job for you. The money's good. I need gas stamps. They're worth a fortune now because of the gas shortage.
Where can we get them?
In the Office of Price Administration.
That's a federal government agency. Isn't that a little risky?
What? Too much for you?
No. Just trying to think of how we can pull it off.
It can't be that hard. The stamps are kept in the safe at night, but the keys are probably around here somewhere.
You got somebody inside?
Yeah, one of our guys. His sister works there.
Can she help us out?
Ask her yourself. Her name's Maria Agnello. Here's the address. Tell her I say.
All right, what about the safe? What if the keys aren't there?
That's your problem.
But what's the job pay?
I'll give you $600 for 10,000 gallons worth of stamps.
Okay, we're in.
No, no, I need Vito to do this alone. I got another job for you, Joe.
So? What do you say, Bureau?
Yeah, sure.
Hey, and don't forget to take a piece with you. You never know what's gonna happen. Better to be safe than sorry. I got beef.
Wait. This isn't some liquor store stick-up. I want this to be a clean job. If you kill anybody, your cut drops to a third. Gabish?
Yeah, I got it. No problem.
Okay, when you're done, you come back in, we'll settle up.
All right, I'll see
you. Good luck, Vito.
Okay, take care.
Can I help you?
Yeah, hello, ma'am. Henry Tomasino sent me. He said he might be able to help me with a little problem down at the Office of Price Administration.
Yeah, I heard about that. What do you need from me?
I need to get in there tonight.
All right, tell you what. My sister's in the hospital right now. If you give me a lift over there, I'll tell you everything you need to know. It's right across the street from the OPA, so it ain't like you're gonna be going out of your way.
Sure, no problem.
Okay, let's go. And take it easy behind the wheel, all right? I seen the way you kids drive these days. All right, kid. The place is locked up pretty tight at night, so you gotta get into the back.
They keep the back door open at night?
No, but the basement window usually is, so that's how you can get in. You're looking for the safe, right?
Yeah, how'd you know?
Lucky guess. It's on the top floor. So's the director's office. That's where the keys are.
Okay. So I go in through a window around the back, then head upstairs to the director's office, right?
Right. And be careful, there's guards in there at night. Don't let them see you. All right, kid. Drop me at the hospital right here. The office is across the street. Okay, thanks for the ride, kid.
Thanks, Maria. I'll see you.
You got any plans for the weekend?
Yeah. Gonna relax and watch me some television.
Well, you bought a television?
I sure did.
Man, those things cost as much as a car. How the hell have you afford it?
Mary's Uncle Lou passed away a few months back, left us some cash.
And you bought yourself a television with it.
Okay, this is the director's office. This is where the key should be. All right, here's the key. Now I gotta get to the safe.
7-inch black and white screen gets all 3 channels.
Wow, sounds fascinating.
What, you mean you ain't gonna get one?
I'll stick with my newspaper with my radio, thank you very much. This television's just a fad.
We'll see about that, sonny boy.
Yeah, so what does Mary think of it?
She ain't seen it yet.
And with my radio, thank you very much. This television's just a fad.
We'll see about that, sonny boy.
Yeah, so what does Mary think of it?
She ain't seen it yet.
Visiting a mother upstate.
Oh, yeah, I see. And, what have you been watching on that fancy television set of yours?
Mostly cartoons. They ain't got much on right now, on account of the war.
Cartoons? All that money to watch some cartoons.
Salesman said when the war is over, they're supposed to start showing ball games on it, too.
Yeah, I'll believe it when I see it.
But listen, I was watching them cartoons. And it give me an idea.
Oh, here we go. Okay, Einstein, let's hear it.
Ah, oh, damn it.
Now, listen to this. What if you could control the cartoon?
What do you mean?
You know, control. You can make the little guy on the screen do things. You can make him run around, drive a car, maybe even, have to shoot a gun, shoot things with it.
Have you been sniffing glue? How the hell are they gonna do that?
Listen, I ain't worked that out yet. You'd probably have to have some sort of box with buttons on it that controls the guy on the screen. I mean, one button would make him walk, the other would make him shoot, one would maybe make him cut.
Oh, yeah, that's your brilliant idea, huh? That sounds interesting, but it ain't never gonna happen.
Oh, yeah? I'm sure someone will figure it out someday, and you can mark my words on it.
Uh-huh. No, they will. Right after they put a guy on the board.
Just
yourself with that number two pencil.
We have you surrounded. Come out with your hands up.
That's what I did. You ought to see this thing. 7-inch black and white screen gets all three channels.
Wow, sounds fascinating.
What, you mean you ain't gonna get one?
I'll stick with my newspaper and with my radio, thank you very much. This television's just a fad.
We'll see about that, sonny boy.
Yeah, so what does Mary think of it?
She ain't seen it yet.
Mom,
how'd you make out?
Things got out of hand. There was nothing I could do about it.
We had an agreement. Remember? You only get a third of the money if there's any shooting.
Let's see what we got here. Ah, shit.
Something wrong?
You bet your ass there's something wrong. These stamps you took have an expiration date. And that date is tomorrow.
So, what exactly does that mean?
It means they're gonna be fucking worthless. But wait. If you can get them to the gas station attendants by midnight, they'll be able to stamp them and redeem them.
You better bring them to every gas station in town.
They gotta get there by midnight or we're screwed. If you don't sell them in time, you get nothing.
Wait a minute, that wasn't our deal. You didn't say anything about any expiration dates.
Well, shit happens, doesn't it? Look, you pull this off, I won't forget it, trust me. Now get going. The faster you unload them, the more money you get.
Hey, interested in buying some gas stamps?
Sure. Just keep this between you and me, all right?
No problem. Just make sure you do the same.
Sure. Sounds good to me.
Hey, I got some extra gas stamps. Interested?
Yeah, sure. I'm interested.
All right, here you go. Fork over the dough.
Sure. Here's your money.
Thanks, pal. Now forget you saw me. Listen, I got these extra gas stamps. You want them, they're yours. Cheap.
Yeah, all right. I'm good with that.
All right, here you go. And keep your mouth shut about this, all right?
Sure thing, buddy. It'll be our secret.
It better be. Hey, you in the market for some surplus gas stamps?
Sure. Where'd you get them? On second thought, I don't even want to know.
Smart man. All right, now fork over the dough.
Yeah, all right. Just hope I don't get in trouble for this.
Don't worry about it. Just keep your mouth shut. Hey, I got some extra gas stamps. You interested?
Yeah, sure. I'm interested.
All right, here you go. Fork over the dough.
Sure. Here's your money.
Thanks, pal. Now forget you saw me. Shit, it's after midnight. Okay, well, I guess that's a bust. I should go back to Joe's.
Evening, mister.
Full tank, please.
Sure thing, pal. Sorry about the prices, but gas keeps going up. It's tough times all around, you know? Here you are.
Thank you.
Come back anytime.
Look at this. Didn't know Joe could even write.
We got another job. Something really big. Stop by Freddy's tonight. Bring a piece and some lockpicks.
Who's here? Where the hell you been? Laying around in bed all day?
Hey, I'm entitled to a little rest after that last job, don't you think?
What can I get you, sir?
Coffee.
Just for now. But when Alberto hears about this, the shit is gonna hit the fan. Believe you me.
So, I heard you didn't score too big last night.
Well, it wasn't exactly my fault. Shit happens.
All right, come on, relax, fellas. It's a high-risk business. If you don't like it, you can always go break your back working for peanuts down at the docks.
Sorry, Henry, I was just breaking balls, you know. So how about tonight? We still on for what we talked about yesterday?
We'll see in a minute.
That is too fucking much, too fucking many. I want my money!
What? Think I'm running some kind of fucking charity here? Do it. Now!
Who was that?
Somebody you don't need to know right now. All right, listen up. There's a guy who owes the boss some money. He borrowed it to open some big jewelry store. He's not paying it back fast enough. We're gonna collect his payment tonight. In jewels. Plus, a little extra for our trouble. Joe, fill him in.
The jewelry store's in the shopping mall in the middle of town. There's no guards at night. So all we gotta do is pick the lock and waltz right in.
Sounds a little too simple.
Because it is simple. Why's everything got to be so fucking complicated with you?
Says the guy who can barely change a light
bulb. Look, don't worry. I thought of everything. I got these phone company uniforms so we can pretend to be fixing something.
Fair enough. Let's go.
All right. We're gonna rob this fuck blind. All we gotta do is wait until dark. Hey, so how'd it go with the port?
What, you mean with Derek?
Yeah, he's a piece of work, ain't he? Give you a job?
Yeah. I worked some guys over. But it was small-time crap. He shakes down these hard-up dock workers just like he did my old man.
Well, you didn't have to do it. It's not like he forced you to work for him, is it?
My mother almost did.
Quit whining and keep in touch with Derek. Trust me, he's got better jobs than shaking down wharf rats. Vito, open this door.
What the hell is this?
Come on, boys. The cops will be here any minute. Move it!
Ryan fucking O'Neill?
What the fuck is this?
You crazy bastard, what the fuck are you doing?
Barbaro, what the hell are you doing here, you fuck?
You're a little late, Chief. There's nothing left here
fuck
for you.
Fuck off, Fatso. This is our heist. You want to get out of here in one piece, you'd better hand over everything you've got.
Well, the sign outside didn't say Brian O'Neill's place. If it did, I wouldn't have robbed it. Instead, I would have set it on fire.
Reported at the West Side Mall. Repeat, 1031. Burglary
this
in progress.
This is car 54. We're on it.
And I suggest you get lost before the cops show up.
Ah, fuck!
Kiss my ass.
Get the fuck out of here.
We gotta get the fuck out of here.
What the hell are you waiting for? Get him, lads!
Brian, what about the cops?
I'm trying!
Get the goddamn jewelry!
Shit! Cops!
Hey, Vito, I got it open! Come on!
Watch my ass while I open this door.
Keep those assholes off my back! Almost got it! Hold them off just a little longer! Come on, you piece of shit, open up!
Okay, cut. We're out of here. Vito, come on!
Freeze! Police! There's no way out!
Fuck! Shit! Shit, another dead end. We gotta get the fuck out of here.
What the hell are you waiting for? Get him, lads!
Brian, what about the cops?
Come on, let's get out of here!
Screw the cops! Get the cops!
I'm trying!
Shit! Cops! Wipe my ass while I open this door. Keep those assholes off my back! Almost done! Hold them off just a little longer. Come on, you piece of shit, open up!
Okay, got it. We're out of here. Vito, come on!
Freeze! Police! There's no way out!
Another dead end. We gotta go this way. It's our only shot. Come on, Vito, move your ass.
What are you, fucking crazy? It's covered in ice. Police. One slip and we're dead.
We got no choice. I ain't going to the joint. Your ass over here. You waiting for a formal fucking invitation?
Over there! Shoot!
Jesus, be careful. Almost lost you there.
Yeah, I think I just shit myself.
Where'd they go? They must have gone this way, Sarge. Oh, fuck that. I don't get paid enough for this.
This way. This should take us to the street. Almost got it. Hold them off just a little longer. We're out of here. Vito, come on.
Hey, fuck nuts, what's the...
Henry's never gonna believe this. Stupid bastards. Let's go.
Fuck off, copper. I didn't do nothing.
Look at the Irish, my ass.
Who the hell was that?
Brian O'Neill. Crazy Mick bastard. Not too bright. Usually works his hired muscle.
Yeah, I didn't think he was the brains of the operation.
Shit, the cops. Come on, get out of the light. Let's go. Come on, come on, come on.
Don't worry. Give me a bag. I'll go ditch the goods. All right, pal. Meet you back home. Try not to get pinched on the way there.
Units, code green, back to the station. Suspect is about 6 feet tall, dark hair, medium build.
Copy that. hurt me! Don't hurt me! Run!
Suspect is about 6 feet tall, dark hair, medium build.
Copy that.
Hey there, handsome.
Hi there.
Joe ain't here right now. He said for you to meet him for lunch at Freddy's.
I see.
Too bad you were passed out when I came in. We could have partied. Maybe next time, doll. Bye.
Huh. That was something.